Altimeter Growth Corp, taking the Singapore-based ride-hailing, delivery, and financial services, and just about everything else company, Grab, public in a transaction that values that firm at $40 billion. Altimeter's Brad Gerstner joins us now exclusively. Congratulations. Good to see you. Now you get to take the trophy now, the biggest SPAC deal ever.
Well, it's great to be back, Scott, and I love the banter between Josh and Steph. And I'm thinking about a lot of the same things, but I think we can all agree that when you look out over 2 to 3 years, you want to be invested in technology. And when I came on last fall to talk about our investment in the Snowflake IPO, or earlier this year to talk about our investment in the Roblox direct list, I said, we're really not in the SPAC business. You know, we're in the business of partnering with the most important technology companies in the world at all stages of growth. And one of those stages is as they step into the public markets. And so when you think about Grab today, they're leveraging the full complements of the Altimeter Capital Markets platform to go public. And it's one of those companies. We're thrilled to invest in it. It's an iconic global internet business, the category leader in mobility, in delivery, and in payments in a very large and fast-growing region in Southeast Asia. So we couldn't be happier than to partner with Grab and take this next step into the public markets.
What do you make of the reaction of the stock we're looking at, your SPAC, that it's down today? What should viewers take away from that?
Well, I don't spend a lot of time thinking about one day movements. The fact of the matter is, it looks like it's up, from the $10 reference price by over 30%. We'll let ultimately the market determine what fair value is for the business. We're placing our bets. People know where we stand. And we think in the fullness of time, as people understand the business, they'll realize that this is a spectacular investment, just as Sea Limited has been for many investors in Southeast Asia.
We are looking at a valuation, as I said, of some $40 billion. That doubles what it was about 18 months ago, Brad. That's certainly raised some eyebrows. I want you to listen to the comments earlier today between Jim Cramer, David Faber, who follow SPACs closer than anybody else, about this valuation. We can react on the other side. Here's those two guys.
Valuation based on what? What happened at the company that it got doubled? Tell me, David.
I don't have an answer for you, and I think that's the appropriate question to be asking at this point.
It is the appropriate question to be asking. What's the answer?
Well, first, let me say, when I came on air and talked about SPACs, I think Cramer's approach to a healthy dose of skepticism about all valuation is a good one. Everybody should do their homework. Everybody should do their diligence and form their own opinions. We've done ours. What was missing from that segment was any context or numbers. What's happened in the last 18 months is dramatic growth. And so you're looking, let's break down the business into its three components. You have the fastest growing and market leading rideshare business in all of Southeast Asia. Remember, this is 650 million people in this market in a much earlier stage of digital penetration than the US, so growing much faster. Their profit margins in each of those markets, as far as we can tell, are the highest rideshare profit margins of any company on the planet. Number two, in delivery, they are the market leader in every country in delivery. This is not only food, but also groceries. Think DoorDash or Uber Eats plus Instacart. And then on top of that, they're starting to deliver all what I call instant commerce, all the things that you might want to have delivered in the next 2 to 3 hours. So that is a massive TAM, a growing business, and we're in the early single-digit penetrations in that business. And I think they've already mentioned they're profitable in 5 out of the 6 markets. And the third business, which is probably the one that's most controversial but the most exciting, is the fintech payments business. In this part of the world, there's very low credit card penetration. It's still largely a cash economy. There is no PayPal. There is no Venmo. There is no Affirm, buy now, pay later. There is no digital banking. And they've spent the last 3 years procuring the licenses, investing aggressive amounts of money to build out that entire fintech stack. our belief is that not only is their digital wallet already the largest in the region, the Malaysian government used it to distribute COVID stimulus checks. But we think it will be one of the largest payments and fintech businesses in the region and on the planet before all is said and done.